Okay, student, in last class, we discussed the concept of star schema, how to implement the star schema. As in that schema, we see that we are having one fact table, that is the internet sale, that is a fact table, and which is surrounded by the different dimension table. Those dimension table are customer, date, and product. The primary key of these dimension table are used as a foreign key in a fact table. All the dimension table are directly connected with the fact table. Now, we don't have a data in this dimension, table and fact table. If we check it over here, we are having the schema name is there, sale DB, right click, and top 100 records, we have nothing over here. Table are still empty. No record is available over here. If we check any other dimension table, we don't have anything in the dimension table. Where we have to take the data? We have to take the data from the adventure work 2019. So for that one, we have to create the SSIS package. In SSIS package, we have to integrate data from source to destination. Our destination is here. That is the sales DB and three different dimension table and one fact table. So how we can create? So in SSIS package, first of all, we have to drag the data flow task. Double click it over here. Now, we have to perform the different data flow and data flow task. We have to take the data from the source component as well as destination component. So we have OLEDB source. So what should be a source over here? Double click it over here. First of all, we will take the data from the adventure work data. So click it over here new. And adventure work source is already available, but at first time we are taking it data directly. We are creating the new collection. Click it over here on new. Now in the connections, we have server, we have to write the server names, or even we can use it over a localhost. Simply press it over a dot, so it connects with the localhost. The database, enter a database name, so we select it over here, adventure work DW 2019, select this one, test connection, connection is succeeded, click it over here, okay, and okay. Now again we have to click over here, okay. So first we have to select the table. Which one table we have to select it over here? For the customer table, we have to take the data from the two different table. First one is the DIM customer, and second one is the DIM geography. First, we have to take the data from the DIM customer table. List of the columns are available. We have over here, first name, middle name, last name, customer key, geography key, and others are there. So at this stage, we are selecting all the columns. Click it over here on OK button. But what we have to do as in our destination, if you remember that one, we use it over here, the full names, while in the source we have the value, that is the first name, middle name, and last name, while at the destination we have full names. What we have to do for the full name, we have to apply the derived column transformations. So how we can apply the transformation over here? So check it over here in the common. We will have the derived column transformation is here. Drag it and drop it over here. Now, precedence error. Move this error to the derived column. Here, source name is here. That is the DIM customer. Derived column, double click it over here. We will find the different list of the columns are there. So we have to select the columns. Here we can select the column, first name, drag it over here. Then we have to apply, use the space, so use it over here plus. Concatenate first name with the last names. Then we have to use the double quotation marks and then space. Then again plus. If we want to use the middle names, yes, we can use it over here middle name. And then again use the plus. If, and then plus, we have a last names. If there is any error, then there will be a red color. As here there is no error, so it means that is working properly. derived column, we have to add a new column. Yes, we have to add the new column. So column name, we want to use it over here. Any column name, we can use it over here. So we are using it over here, full name that we need it. Click it over here. Okay. Now we perform the one transformation, and that is the concatenate first name, middle name, and last name to the full name. One. After that one, we have to take the data from the geography dimension table. So what we can do it over here, just copy it. And then we have to paste it over here. First one is a dim customer, second one is a dim geography. And whenever we are taking data from these two, we have to create the joins among both of these. For the joins, dim geography, and we have to select it over here, the geography table. Adventure work source is okay. Now table name, we have to change it over here. Select the table name, that is the dim geography. Click over here, okay. Now when we have to apply joining, to apply the join, we have to use the merge join. But before applying merge join, as you people already know, that we have to apply the sorting of the data. So first sorting, and then we may be able to apply the join. To sort it, drag, press in this arrow. Sort will be performed over here based on the, let me say, that geography key that is available in both of these tables. Click over here on OK. Sorting will be performed on the ascending order. OK. So here again, dim geography. Press in this arrow, drag and drop to the sort one. And then again, we have to apply it over here. Geography ascending order 1, sort order key, that is the 1. Click over here, okay. Now after this one, we have to apply the merge join, drag and drop this one. Press it inside, move it over here. Now left merge, left input joins, okay. For this one sort, again we have to use it over here. This one will be considered as the right output join. So double click it over here. Which time of the join we have to apply? We want to apply it over here. Inner join, all the columns from the customer table, customer dimension table. And let me say that we are taking also all the column from the geography dimension table. Or even if we don't want to take all the columns, we don't need the country code regions and the destination columns at the destination. Or we don't need the Spanish, we don't need the French country region names. So no need of that one. We don't need the postal code, sale territory key, IP address locator. We don't need it. Click over here. Okay. Now merge join is done. After that one, we have to use the destination. So which one destination should be here? As we have to move the data to our destination. Already schema is implemented as we implemented in the last class. Now move it over here, press inside, double click over here. Which one should be our destination? So that adventure work is our source. While we are having the destination, that is here. Sales DB is our destination. That is already added over here. Select it, click over here on OK. Now which one table should be here? So we say that table should be here. That is a customer table should be here. Now after that one, it is very necessary to click on mapping and perform the mapping. Now for the customer DW key, we don't need mapping, as the value of customer DW key will be automatically generated. Full name value will be taken from the full name, birth date, email, meta status, gender, education. For education, it is not create the mapping, as column and source and destination are not matched. Why? Because at the source we are having the English education. We have a English education. For occupation, at the source we have a English occupation. City names in both source and destination are the match. While state province names, here we see that at the destinations, what we have? State province code, state province name. At the source we are having state province name, while destination we are having just state province. Country region, so far that is, and we are having the in English country region names. For age, we are not taking the value. Why? Because we are already using the case statement, and the value of the age is calculated from the birth date. And the current flag, we are ignoring it over here. Why? The reason is that current flag value will be automatically taken at implementation time. We use it over here, default value, that is 1. Click it over here on OK button. Okay, let's see that full name length is 152. Let's see if there is something wrong. We have to make change over here. Execute it at this stage. If everything is fine, it will work properly. Move the data from source to destination. It takes the 655 rows from the customer geography. It takes the 18,484 rows from the customer dimension table. Now, all the data has moved from the 18,484 rows from source to destination. Package is executed properly. Done. Now, first one, data is moved to the customer dimension table. Now, previously when we checked it over here, that in customer dimension table there was no data. Now, if we check it over here in the customer dimension table, like this one is there, re-execute it. Data is moved to the source to destination. Now, we have a data at the customer dimension table. Data is taken from the two different dimension table and moved to the one dimension table, that is a customer dimension. Now we want to next one dimension, that we are having the product dimension. For the product dimension table, we have to take the data from the three dimension table or three different table. What are those table are there? First one is the product, second one is the subcategory, and third one is the category. Just copy and paste. We have to make the change the name of, like we want to take it over here, dim product. Double click it over here or edit it. We have to select the dim product. Dim product is here. Check the columns. At this stage, we are taking all the columns. Click it over here on OK. Next one, we want to use it over here, the dim subcategory and then dim category. This one will be considered as a dim category, and then again we are having the dim subcategory. Then subcategory and then category. So just change name out over here. Then category. Okay, first then subcategory. What the name that you can write it over here? If spellings are wrong, nothing will be happened. There is no problem. There is no issue, as we can assign any names over here. So we have to select it over here, the dim product subcategory, and Adventure Work DW2019 is the source. Click over here. Okay, our product subcategory is selected. Then we have to go for the next one, product category. I'm just writing short name, product cat. Double click it over here and then select it over here, dim product category. Click it over here on list of the column. Okay, now again we have to create a join among these three tables. So first create a join between product category and product subcategory, and then combination of that one giant with the product, then product. So how we can create the giant? For that one, we have to use the merge sort or merge giant. So before applying the merge giant, first we have to apply the sorting of the data. So product subcategory, double click over here. So based on which columns we have to create the giants, so the sorting. So that is a product category key. Select this one, click over here, okay. Next one, we have sort over here. Now here, drag and drop. So which one column that we have to use? Product subcategory, product category key. Click over here, okay. Now when sorting of this one is done, after that one, we may be able to apply the merge giants. Drag and drop. Now this one will be considered as a, you can consider it left or right, anyone. Merge left input, okay. If this one is left input, so next one, this one will be dim product category, will be considered as a right input. Double click it over here. Now we have to apply it over here, the inner giant. Fine. What are the different column that we needed? As we said, that we needed product category, subcategory key. We needed the English product set category names. Other column names, we don't need it. Even if we want to take it over a product key, fine, although we don't need it. Then we say that English product category name, we need it. Click it over here, okay. Merge giant is done. Now, we have to create this giant with these. This one will be giant with the name product. So what, again, we have to apply the sort over a name product. Now, based on which one column, let me say that product subcategory key, we have to apply the giant, okay. And if we are having the merge giant is there, again, we have to apply over here the sorting of this one. Remember that one. If we are not applying the sorting, we may lead to the incorrect result or there will be an error message. Double click over here. Which one?
Excuse me, sir.
Subcategory key. Yes, please.
So what is difference between merge operation and merge join operation?
Well, whenever we are merging the data or merging of the different two tables, it means the table structure must be the same, right? Both of those tables must have the same type of the table structure, like employee ID, employee name, employee address, and salary. In one, employee one as well as in employee two. While whenever we are applying the merge join, it is not necessary both of these are having the same structure. This one, merge join, is just like a simple join. There must be a primary key and foreign key. Primary key of one table will be is used as foreign key in any other table. Based on the primary key, we may be able to take the data from two different table. While in merge statement, what we have to do? In merge statement, just we are combining the data from two different table, and the table structure must be same. Is it clear?
Yes, it's clear. Thank you, sir.
Okay. So here we did apply it over here, merge join. After that one, we are applying the sorting. In sorting, based on the which one column we are applying over here, just check it out, product key. Okay. Now, when sorting is done, after that one, now we may be able to apply it over here, the merge join again over here. So to create the join among these tables. This one is considered the left input. Merge left, click over here, okay. Now this one is here, okay. Now double click over here. Now it may be possible, like here we are having the inner giant. We can select the left outer giant or full outer giant. Well, we can select it over here left. Reason is that one, or we will select it over here left. Reason is that one. Let in the left table we are having the product, in right table we are having the product category and subcategory. It is not necessary that all the product have a category or subcategory, right? So for that reason, we are applying the left outer join. If there is no join between the product and product subcategories, then still it will display all of those records that are available in the product table. So we have to create a giant, select all of these columns, click over here on OK button. Now merge join is done. Now we have to use it over as a destination table. So just we have already have the connection with there. So just copy it and paste it. Drag and drop. Now double click, and which one table we have to select over here? Now this one we have to select it over here, the product dimension table, and destination is here says DB. We have to check it over here, the product dimension table. Click on mapping, as all the mapping will not be performed. Product key value will be moved to the product key. Product name at the source, we see that what we have English product names. Just check it out. Color values and size column names are sent. That's the mapping is performed. Category names, we are having the English category names. Sorry, this one is a subcategory. English product subcategory names, and then for the category names again we are using the English product category name. Click over here on OK button. Now done. If we re-execute it, what will be happened? As we are having the data in the already data is available in the customer dimension table, and we are again reloading the data. What will be happened? It means that same data will be reloaded. So to avoid that one situation, what we can do it over here? We can use it over here, execute SQL task. Execute SQL task. And then we have to create the connection with the destination. Destination is here, localhost sales DB. And we have to write the SQL statement. And what is those SQL statement? We want to delete it. Delete. If we are having already data is available in the table, so we have to delete. Delete from. Table is here, customer. Name is here, customer. Delete all the data from the customer table. If you have a data, and before executing the package, previous data will be removed, and then new data will be loaded. Then again, for the second one is here, product. Delete from. Table name is here. Just check it out. First one is their customers, and second one is their product. Product. Click over here on OK button. OK. Now drag this one and drop it. Double click over here. Here warning is, we are having the warning because of the full name size. As size is getting increased, that's why it is displaying the error message. That we can, even if we want to remove whatever are the like the value of this one middle name, hope that will problem will be resolved. But no, there is no issue if it is displaying the warning. Click over here on OK button. Re-execute it. So it will move data from the again already available data that we are having the customer dimension table will be removed from the customer table and then reload the data. And similarly, it will load the data from the product dimension table, take the data from product subcategory and category table to the product dimension table. If you people have any question till now, you may ask please. No question? It is taking data from source to destination. Level here, it takes data from product table and product category and product subcategory and move join it over here. 37 different records are there that perform the matching, and then it perform it over here, the sorting of that 137 those records, and then merge it over here. 606 rows are moved to the product dimension table, and same over here for the customer dimension table, 18,484 rows are moved to the customer dimension table. Even if 100 times we re-execute it, what the table we are having, the data is there, previous data will be removed and the new data will be loaded. Just check it out. Here execute SQL task is completed successfully. Stop it. Now we are having two different dimensions, data is done. Now we are having the third dimension, and third dimension is related to the Data dimension, that is very easy task. Just no other join is needed. We have to take data from one table. So now here we have to select the third one dimension that we have a dim date, and the source we are having the dim date. So select the dim date. List of the columns, all column we are selecting at this stage. Okay, and what should be a destination? So we have to select the destination. Take data from source and move to the destination. So here source name should be here, dim date. Always mention the name over here. Although that is not the basic requirement, but if you want to re-execute it, if you want to modify your package, then that is very necessary that you must have a proper names. So now here we have to select the destination. So dimension should be here, date. We have to perform the mapping. So mapping date key value, full date. For that one, we are having the full alternate date, month number. Here we are having the day number of the month. For the calendar quarter and calendar month, values are okay. Fine, clicked over there, okay. Now, again, now we are having the date dimension is here. Again, we have to edit over here, date dimensions. If we have a data and date dimension, that will be removed. So for date dimension, what is the name over here? Table name is here, dates. Clicked over here, okay. And okay. So that is execute SQL task. As we said in control flow, order of operation is defined. And condition under which those operations are performed. So what is the order of operation? First, delete all the records. If you are having table are already available, data is already available in the table, delete all the records and then perform the loading of the data. That is the control flow. And data flow, different ETL operations are performed over here. Now re-execute it. Now in this way, we load all the data from source to destination into three different dimension table. After that one, we are having the fact table. So for fact table, always remember that one whenever we have to load the data. So load the data in the different or use the different separate package for the fact table. And the reason is that one, it parallelly loads the data from the different table. Like it is loading the data in the customer dimension table. At the same time, it's loading the data in the product as well as in the date. But whenever we, if we use it over here, the next dimension table or fact table, so it try to load the data, take the data from the these sources, these values. So maybe it may be possible that data is not already loaded, so the things will not properly work. So I'll, for the fact table, create the separate package. Now it moved the data into the date dimension, 3652 records in the product dimension, 606 rows, as well as in customer dimension, 18,484 rows are moved. Now, next one, we have to go for the fact table. For the fact table, data will be taken from the two different table. One is we are having the this one customer dimension table. From the customer dimension table, we are using the customer DW key, while for all the other values, fact internet sale that is available in the adventure work. So for that one, we have to add the new package over here. Right click, new package. So for this one package, what I have to do, data flow task, drag it, double click it over here. Now we have to select the source. So which one should be a source? OLEDB is the source. Now, what should source name should be here? We have to select our new. First one source should be here, AdventureWorks 2019. And table is here, set internet sale. Click it over here on the columns. At this stage, we are selecting the all columns, okay. And next one source, just copy it and paste it. First one is here, set internet sale. Next one, we have the customer. So that is available our current DB. That is the sale DB. So here we have to select it over here. That is not available over here. Click new. And that is available over here, the sale DB. Customer dimension table is available in sale DB. Where we are having sale is here. Click column. Okay. Now we have to go for the joining of the data. Apply the merge join. So again, we have to apply the sorting of the data. First sort. Based on which one column we want to apply the join, we see that customer key. We have to apply the join. Then again, here we are having from customer. We have to apply the customer key. Click over here. Okay. Now joining is sorting is done. After that one, we have to apply the merge join. This one, okay. Left and this one. Double click over here. We have to apply the inner join. All the column values that we want to take it over here from source and destination. From here, we just need is here customer DW key. All the other column value, we don't need it over here. Click over here, okay. Now, after that one, we have to select the destination and other destination OLEDB destination will be selected. Drag and drop. Now, what should be destination over here? Our destination should be here. Sales DB, from the sales DB, destination should be here. Internet sale and mapping. For the mapping, we see that internet sale, fine. We are, this one is our surrogate key, no value. Product key value is taken from product key. Date key, it see that we are having the order key is here. From the order quantity, we are having order quantity. Sale amount, value will be taken from the sale amount. Unit price, value is taken from the unit. And then the SQL statements, what is the delete from? Table name. What is our table name is our internet sales? Delete from internet sales. Click over here. Okay. And okay, execute it. Just execute it, then data will move from source to destination. If there is any error, then always check the progress tab. Execute task process is done properly, then data flow task is executing. Now let's see. Now that is also done. 18,000 records are taken from the customer dimension table. 60,000 records are taken from the fact internet sale table, and then perform the sorting and then merge join, and 60,398 rows are transformed into the destination table. Now in this way, we may be able to transform the take the data from the source and move data to the destination. So here we created two different packages. On these two packages, we take the data for the customer dimension table, product dimension table, and as well as the date dimension table, and move to the destination. Similarly, we take this in another package, we take the data for the fact table from the different sources and then move it over here.